Welcome back to our special event exclusive coverage of Dell's CES 2025 preview. My name is Savannah Peterson. Very excited to be talking to you about more of the great announcements that came out of Dell this morning. This time on the display side, no one better to show it to me than Mike. Mike, thanks for coming to hang out. You're so ready.
Yes.
So, based on your body language alone, I can tell you're pretty pumped up about the display announcements today. Yeah. We're all worried about our eyeballs. We're all wanting things to be better visually. What are some of the improvements that you've made here? I mean, even just looking at these two displays, I can see a pretty dramatic difference here. I'll get out of the way so the camera can see it. Talk to me about the innovation here.
Okay, there's a couple of things happening here. First, this is the best-selling 32-inch 4K display off of Amazon's website. So that's the comparison that we've got here. We do have some video B-roll showing other things where we show current generation of Dell versus next generation of Dell with reflectivity and stuff. But this is not us and us. This is a VA LCD, vertical aligned. Now, VA has always been good at some things and not as good at other things. In this instance, what we're focusing on here is the contrast, because IPS, in-plane switching, sometimes folks have said, I can't get as black of blacks, like I feel like I get some IPS glow, different things like that. And while IPS has become much better at metering light over time, this is really a step function improvement. So this is IPS black, the new generation, shun. That's free audio effects. So in a nutshell, we went from 1,000 to 1 to 2,000 to 1 last generation. Now we're at 3,000 to 1 contrast. And in addition to doing that, we're also decreasing the reflectance of the screen from about 9% to about 5%. So if you look at the image here, what you see is along the top of the skyline, you see a gradient that goes from light blues to dark blues. It looks better here. If you look down in the foreground, you see what looks like deep green, beautiful turf versus a little bit washed out green. But what really brings it home for me is if you look at the buildings themselves, the areas where you have a dark building with a white light that's very, very small, those little pinpricks of light where you can get bright and dark so close together is really the essence, nay, dare I say, the definition of contrast.
That was good. That was good. I'm following you. Yeah. And it really does. I have to point out, even when we sat down and were just exploring before you so kindly came over to educate us, you could tell right away. I mean, this looks older. This looks washed out. This looks almost like a different time of day entirely because it's so fuzzy when it comes to that contrast like you're talking about. Beyond it being visually stunning, I'm under the impression there are some health benefits to this monitor or to this display as well.
Yes. Okay, there are some health benefits. So now I'm gonna use a cool device to show the health benefits. So let me show you what the device is. We've got this little lens there, and that little lens there is gonna let light and color less than 430 nanometers of wavelength through, and it's gonna block everything above that. About 460 or so, we're going to start to get red, green, yellow, those kinds of colors. And so it'll eliminate all those colors. And what we're looking for is how much of the blue it lets through, because what the health benefit would be is if I have less of that harmful blue light that comes through about 440 nanometers and goes way back in my eyes, that tells my brain, stay wired, stay alert, stay awake. And if I'm working on something at night and then I try and lay down and go to sleep, then my brain is really stimulated. It can dry your eyes out too, but really the biggest thing is trying to get to sleep after you've been working on this puppy. So let's check it out. I'm gonna change a couple of images here. So I'm gonna do a little Alt-Tab magic. If you need more keyboard shortcuts, just look them up on the internet. And then what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take a knee and I'm gonna kind of show this. Okay, so you can see on the left-hand side, and you can see here, I've got some words. Wellness-focused technology, the world's best eye comfort. Oh, it looks like I can read something that says damaging blue light. Now, let me look over here on the Dell. Oh, I can kind of make those letters out, but not nearly as much. Now, on this one, I'm going to look, and I see I eliminated all the higher colors in the nanometer wavelength, like I mentioned, the reds, the yellows, all that kind of stuff. Look inside the center ring. I've got a slice of the pie in the bottom right quadrant and two dots on the bottom left. Now watch as I shift over to the Dell. I can still see that they're there, but much less so.
Wow.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay.
That was fantastic. So benefits of this being eye strain, meaning you can hang out on your computer longer. What other sort of functionality do you think this is going to bring to your fabulous community?
Now listen, I don't want to be a tearjerker here, but this is the way I think about it. I work all day, okay? You work all day, you work all day, and you're working, your eyes are a muscle, the muscle gets tired. You get home and you got to take the kids to T-ball or to Girl Scouts or to a million other different activities that the family's involved in. If my battery is more charged at the end of the day and I haven't been drained down as much, for me, that's kind of a big deal, right? And I know it seems a little bit kind of almost sappy, but really the ability to use technology without having a draining effect is really, really nice. Also, I mean, let's face it, you and I, just as an example, we both have beautiful eyes, so you should really take care of them.
I love that. A charmer and a technologist, all wrapped into
one. Can I show you one other
thing? I would love if you showed me one other thing, Mike.
That was a trick. There's actually two, but let me show you this one first. Okay,
but wait, there's two more things? Is that how Dell's going to do it?
Look, I'm going to go in here, and in the menu, I'm going to take the brightness from on to, I'm going to go to something called auto brightness. So I'm going to turn auto brightness on, and when I do that, watch what happens. You can kind of see the numbers change, right?
Oh, wow.
It's actually adjusting the brightness of the screen. Now, I'm going to simulate sunlight with a flashlight. It makes the screen brighter. It makes the screen darker. If it's really dark in the room, it makes the screen even darker. And so essentially what's happening is there's a small light meter on top of the display that is evaluating how bright the display should be so that it's easy for you to work. Okay.
What a novel idea.
Oh, my gosh. So cool. One last thing. Okay, now what we're going to see here is on the left-hand side, we have the U2723QE. That's the Dell product that's shipping right now. And on the right, we have the new version. Look down here in the bottom of the screen at how much light is kind of washing out the color. That's the improved reflectance that I was talking about. Now, if you're thinking to yourself, I've never heard anyone talk about reflectance in displays, that's because it's been a long time since anyone has, right? Nothing's really changed there. Mm-hmm. So you improve the contrast ratio and improve the reflectivity, reduce the reflectivity, and now you've got a screen that can really give you blacker blacks and more shades of every color, which is really, really awesome.
Are you as convinced as Mike is that this is really, really awesome? He's convincing me right now. How long has this been in development?
Forever, ever, ever. No, it hasn't been forever. So this has been in development for, I would say, a couple of years. Our journey with improving the contrast ratio started with IPS Black. We introduced IPS Black on the U2723QE in 2022. And when we started that journey, we knew it was but the first step. And we knew that the second step, when we would make an improvement in not only contrast, but reflectivity, it would really have a greater impact. And so it's been a couple of years in development. And I mean, I have to tell you, I love it.
I really love it too. Do you think that these displays are going to help your community live their best AI-powered lives?
Yes. Yeah. Look, I mean, at the end of the day, a lot of people do a lot of great things with computers, and a lot of people do really creative things and make beautiful things. But there's also a lot of us that look at words and numbers on a screen. And if you're inputting a large data set, or you're reviewing information, or looking at statistics, or reading emails, or writing white papers about technology, it really, really comes down to contrast. Does the foreground and the background have a clear delineation? And so this contrast is really going to help everybody.
I love that. It kind of reminds me of when filters came out for our photos and all of a sudden you could tell the difference in contrast because different features popped or you wanted to hide some features, so you went with a slightly more blurry filter depending on your mood. I think this is really interesting. So we love covering Dell. We're obviously here and we'll also be at Dell Tech World. What do you hope to be able to say when we're hanging out in Las Vegas in May that you cannot currently say here in January at CES?
First and foremost, I should say how grateful I am for my job. And I think that there's always going to be something new coming down the pipeline. We've got a couple of great products here in the displays portfolio we're focused on for CES timeframe, but we're going to have a lot of refreshing in the portfolio in the February-March timeframe, because as we bring the latest in technology to the best in the portfolio in ultra sharp, we're also going to make improvements everywhere else. So there's going to be a lot of exciting stuff that is fairly new in the market around the Dell World timeframe. And I think what we're going to be talking about then is about how many great reviews we've hopefully gotten based on this awesome technology.
I love that. Thank you so much, Mike. This has been very informative, and I wish everyone had this level of enthusiasm that you have about displays. They may not have had it when they started watching this video, but I would be willing to bet they have it now.
Oh, thank you. You're too kind. And thank you for watching along.
You know what? I'm just going to let Mike own the outro there. Stay tuned for more coverage from here at Dell's exclusive CES preview. My name is Savannah Peterson. You're watching theCUBE.